Magiri Manene is a success. He is an inspiration for thousands of cotton farmers of Bura who have seen him grow and prosper. Manene is among the residents of Bura who settled in the scheme when it was established in the early 1980s. Anticipated income from farming was never to be, as canals silted and an impenetrable thicket of the invasive plant known as mathenge spread everywhere.
Sisi tulikuwa tuna chochote, nikianza historia kule nyuma kidogo ya kilimo. Pamba ilikuwa haiuzwi, sasa ndio tulianza. Tena mwezi kama miezi mitatu iliyopita, miezi minne iliyopita ndio tulipanda pamba.
There was little or no crop harvest due to shortage of irrigation water and lack of adequate funds to operate the pumping units. A partnership between the Ministry of Agriculture, the Cotton Development Authority CODA, National Irrigation Board, Cotton Ginneries, Bura Farmers and Equity Bank has restored hope for the farmers.
Ukusaji wa pamba imeanza hapa Bura. Hakuna kurudi nyuma, no turning back.
In the partnership, NIB is responsible for maintenance of canals that channel water to farms in the scheme.
Serikali kupitia Wizara ya Kilimo kwa wakati huu meleta mbegu ili wakulima wapate nafasi ya kupanda chakula ya kutosha. Pamba tumeletewa na CODA. Na watu wa Bura mnasema mnataka tani ngapi mbegu? Kwa vile mko na maji semeni nataka hata tani 100 mbegu tupande ili mpate pesa.
The Farmer Association coordinates the farmers' activities and CODA jointly with the Ministry of Agriculture offer extension services to support farmers in crop husbandry, while Equity Bank provides credit for farm inputs and payment to farmers. Select cotton ginneries committed to buy the lint from the farmers ensured there is a ready market, therefore completing the value chain in cotton farming.
Tunafurahi sana kwamba wakulima mwisho wamekubali kwamba wataweza kukuza pamba katika mashamba yao. Kwa hivyo chochote utakachozalisha shambani mwako kwa jina la pamba tutakuja kukibeba kwa bei hiyo.
Pamba ni mali na tutanunua pamba yenu yote kwa bei ile tutapewa na CODA.
The turnaround in Bura is beginning to be felt by farmers like Manene, an accomplished maize farmer. Persuaded by the ready market offering competitive prices for cotton to feed the textile industry, Manene embarked on cotton farming on a large scale.
Kile kitu mkulima anatakiwa afanye ndio afaidike na hile. Kitu cha kwanza ni kulima na kuweka fertilizer ya kutosha ndio uweze kutoa katika eka moja. Tuseme kwa mfano ukiweka mifuko kama sita katika 1.5 ile, yani eka moja na nusu, unaweza funa kama kilo 3,000 katika hiyo, kutoka kilo 3,000 mpaka kilo 3,000 na nusu.
Huu msimu ambao umepita, nafikiri pesa ile imeingia mkononi mwa mkulima ni kama 24 million ambao imeleta change kubwa sana. Hata town tunaanza kuona ime change vijijini. Watu walikuwa wanatumia mafuta taa, siku hizi wanatumia solar. Na tum business twingi ambao tumechipuka.
This evening, Manene has just returned from Kitui where he had gone to deliver 9 tons of cotton to a ginnery. Kitui Ginneries is among others that have committed to buy cotton grown by the farmers, providing the critical element of market. Manene's success has attracted other farmers to try their hand at cotton production. Wayueni Wakanyi planted his first crop of cotton this season. The high quality grade realized has given him hope for improved yields and volume in the future.
Hii mumea ni ya haraka. Hilo tunavyojua pamba ni mali, ni kweli pamba ni mali. Ukiangalia hii pamba yake ni grade 1. Unaiona? Grade 1 kabisa. Hapa Bura tufuni grade 2. Tukipanda wakati unastahili, tunafaa tunafuna grade 1 kutoka mwanzo mpaka kumalizia. Na hiyo sasa ndio tumeanza kufufuka. Hii ni kilimo ya biashara na pesa. Tunataka kuonja pesa tuone kama tutainuka.
Wajueni has harvested one sack full of fluff today, which weighs almost 30 kilograms. Tomorrow, he expects to deliver by truckload like Manene.
Kilimo hii kinanisaidia. Ninapolima, ile mazao natoa hapo, ile pesa natoa hapo kwa mimea, inanisaidia kulisha watoto yangu, kujibundu kimaisha, kama mtu aliyoanjiliwa.
The crop farming activities in Bura have not only encouraged farmers to increase acreage under cotton, but have persuaded pastoralists to adopt crop farming.
Kama hajapanda hii mapamba hii mashamba ilikuwa imeregea sana ime watu kufa sana. Sasa kidogo tuko iko mzuri sasa kidogo.
Ore is envious of his age mates who have embraced crop farming and are delivering cotton and maize in truckloads. They have bought motorbikes to get about in the expansive farming scheme. The pastoralist confirms that since crop farming was restored, his herd of cattle and goats has multiplied significantly due to the constant supply of foliage from harvested cotton and maize.
Kama sasa hii kuingia huko utaona mashamba ngombe na njaa. Sasa wenyewe kitoa hii chakula, sasa sisi tunaenda kujisaidia hiyo mapua tunaenda kujikatia.
The interrelationship between crop farmers and pastoralists is welcomed by the community as their respective interests will become common.
With a scheme where it's lying at the center of an arid land, you expect a lot of interest in terms of pasture, especially when there is a prolonged drought. So from our production, from cotton, the grasses, and even along the canals, the irrigation canals, you find the pastoralists rearing their animals there.
The guaranteed market for cotton, accessible financing by Equity Bank, and a robust irrigation infrastructure has fundamentally changed the lives of Bura farmers.
Napomaliza hii kifuno ya pamba, sitakosa hata kama ni 5,000.
Most of the Bura cotton farmers have seen their livelihoods improve from the crop they deliver to neighboring counties of Kitui and Makueni.
Bura irrigation scheme used to produce about 40% of what we used to get into the country. But then it collapsed under the NIB and assistance from the Equity Bank. We have tried to do some kind of piloting project in Bura and we realized about 600 acres. And we were buying there two ginneries, Makueni ginneries and Kitui ginneries. And then we as Makueni ginneries, we have already received about 140 tons from Bura.
At the factory, the cotton lint is separated from cotton seed. The lint is cleaned of physical impurities before baling for onward delivery to textile manufacturers. The cotton seed is used for manufacture of animal feed, while syrup generated during the processing is used for manufacture of paints and polishes. The revival of Bura cotton production has consequently supported the restoration of the textile and garment subsector. Bura is now distinguished as a leading source of cotton that is an important component of the trade and industry sector of Kenya. The irrigation scheme is creating employment and reducing poverty within and without its confines, courtesy of a well-thought-out public-private farming partnership.